Pencils are a great tool. They are used for writing, marking as a carpenter's tool, and have a wide use in art and sketching. Now, the thing that makes it unique is that they are erasable. Now, you can erase what you have already put down, which is something you can't do if you use something like a pen. But for pencils, in the long history of writing, they are relatively new. The pencils which are familiar to us today came only about 400 years ago. So here's a short brief history of pencils. Intro. We humans have used different kind of tools to leave marks on things. The earliest known pieces of writings are actually from the Sumerians, and it dates back to about 3200 BC. For example, the Kish tablets which you have found from the state of Uruk in the modern day Iraq is actually a limestone tablet which contains inscriptions of this period. It is one of the oldest pieces of writings which have survived till date. Now, humans had already made a ton of different tools for writing much before anything like pencil was invented. So the story of pencils actually start in the 16th century, when the graphite deposits were discovered in the Borrowdale, England. Locals thought that the dark metallic compound was actually lead, which was commonly used by Romans to make marks on the paper. They widely used the lead stylus. In fact, the drawings from the most famous painters like Leonardo da Vinci are actually from sanguine, chalk, and the metal point. The rough way of writing at that time was actually a gesso-like coating was prepared on a surface, and a thin metal point or a metal rod was actually used to leave marks on that coating. Most of the metal point drawings from that era are actually done in the similar way. These drawings from that time are actually called the silver point, and at that time it was a very limited and a time-consuming process compared to the graphite drawings which we do today. After finding such large deposits of graphite in England, people understood the importance of it, and they understood that this thing could be used to leave some dark, precise marks on paper. So they started manufacturing these thin sticks of graphite, and they were often wrapped around a string. And because of this, they soon started selling it on the streets. This new method of writing also became popular, and the word pencil was actually born, which comes from the Latin word penicillis, a little tail. Englishmen also started using graphite as a material ingredient to make cannonballs, and they took over the control of the Borrowdale mines and established a proper mining facility there. The mining was actually done in a very controlled manner in order to prevent the overuse, and this black lead, as it was given the name at that time because it looked like lead, soon gained its popularity across the whole Europe. There were several more deposits of graphite found in the whole Europe, but these Borrowdale mines produce the darkest and the best in quality marks. But pencils at that time weren't anywhere near the ones which we use today, because graphite was actually very soft and it was no way long lasting. The birth of the modern day pencil actually happened due to the England-France war in the 1790s, when England imposed an embargo on France, stopping all the trade between the two nations. France was short of graphite and pencils. So after almost a year of war, the French Minister of War actually commissioned a scientist and a war commander, Nicolas Jacques Conté, to find the solution. Now, the Conté already had invented the hot air balloon, and in that process, he lost an eye. Now, he was to find a solution to this problem of pencils. Now, Conté soon came up with the idea to use graphite and clay as a mixture. Now, this mixture was actually mixed with water, and then it was hardened into molds, which was then fired in a kiln. Now, in the end of the process, Conté realized that with the varying mixtures of graphite and clay, he could actually alter the hardness and the darkness of the pencil which came out in the result. He would then finally place this stick in a wooden casing, which completed the pencil. Now, this method was actually much more practical, because now we had the independence to choose which variety of pencil do I need. Is it dark or is it light, depending on the purpose. The Contes pencils were a success in Europe, and many different manufacturers also started producing the pencils across the whole continent. Now, coming to the US, earlier Englishmen used to take pencils along with them to the continent, but soon Americans also started playing with different mixtures. Henry David Thoreau, for an instance, mixed graphite with beaver wax or spermaceti, a wax from the sperm whales commonly used to make candles at that time. His pencils weren't of the Contes quality, but his wax mixture with graphite was also one of the best ones available in the US at that time. As the world took up the Contes method of manufacturing, soon factories were established which could easily produce the pencils with the wooden cases according to the need. The German A.W. Faber company, which we today know as the Faber Castell, became so popular that people fake marked their pencils as the Faber pencils in order to make more sales. The John Dixon and Company of the US was the largest consumer of graphite in the world. And by the end of the 19th century, more than 240,000 pencils were used every day in the US. Joseph Dixon created about 132 pencils per minute that resembled this contemporary design. The manufacturers also took up the famous hexagonal shape of the pencils because round pencils were much more likely to slip off the table. And if you are a carpenter or anyone, you know, the pencil will just keep rolling off and it would be extremely annoying. So the hexagonal shape was quite practical. As far as eraser is concerned, earlier people used breadcrumbs in order to erase the pencil marks. But soon people realized that rubber was much more convenient, and soon this whole process of rubber was also developed in order to meet the need. Now you people might think that the mechanical pencils should be a relatively new invention. But actually, it's also more than 100 years old. It actually happened in 1915 when the Japanese metal worker Tokuji Hayakawa invented the ever-ready sharp mechanical pencil. It was as thin as a normal wooden pencil and the lead fits snugly inside. Just rotate the mechanical pencil as you were screwing it in and the lead would just pop out. This design took off around the world and Hayakawa's company would be named as the Sharp Corporation after his pencil. So that's it guys for this one, and I hope you guys liked the video. Smash like, hit subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.